Hello and welcome back to another episode of XCOM 2 War of the Chosen. My name is Syken, and today we're continuing the Tapcat and Syken 2 Against the Overlord campaign. I want to start with confessing a little oopsie. This is an ex post recording after we have done most of the campaign, and I realized that some of the footage was lost due to a hard disk crash. Which brought me into the unfortunate position that I will need to retake episode 42, 44, and 48. I figured it is better to retake them instead of leaving you hang up high and dry without any footage whatsoever. But please bear in mind that whatever you're seeing here might not fully tie up to the next episode where Tapcat is at. This is the unfortunate reality of a content creator's life. Sometimes you're losing content and you need to do the best out of it. So, with that out of the way, what I will do in order to make it up is I'll just choose the most difficult missions that are available to give you some really good action. I'll focus on the tactical gameplay and then we'll kind of cut it off there, because nothing that I'm doing here would like really affect things that are happening afterwards. So please suspend your disbelief for a moment and accept that this is essentially more a plug-in than anything else. Good. So we're going into a protect the device mission. Very difficult. I just wanted to highlight what is in here. Gatekeeper and Advent Witch Killer. So that together screams don't do it. It's not worth it, my dude. And on top of that, protect the device mission. So I'm trying to get out of this mostly unscathed, but we're going to see whether or not I'll be successful. Gatekeeper sucks big times, but so do Advent Witch Killers. Both are not really great. I am wondering if I should move around the Mimic Beacon over here to Mad Dog, because he has grenades. I think that's the right call. And we're giving the good old AP rounds to the guy that hopefully kills the Witch Killers. And a second Mimic Beacon for good measure. So it's very difficult, 13 enemies. That might be the odd chosen on this mission on top of it. And as you can appreciate, protect the device missions are typically not my favorite ones, or anyone's favorite missions for that matter. Let's go. All right, so landed. Let's go. What do we need to do? Protect that device at all costs. We got a couple of rounds to actually go there, so this will be one of those missions where we need to push in relentlessly. Let's just try to be as fast as possible.
Headed there now.
Okay, nothing yet. That is atypical.
Let's do this. Got it. Moving. As you direct.
Okay, well, we made a lot of progress in terms of how far we moved in, but we gotta make sure that we keep a solid formation. I would like to take this high ground here next. So the name of the game will be get in carefully, try to not get spotted out.
We got an enemy squad here.
No, you've got two enemy squads here. And that looks like a Spectre Prime. Oh, wonderful. Two primes. Not good. Moving to full cover.
Moving to designated coordinates.
Again, moving to full cover here.
Moving to designated coordinates.
And this could be a good opener. Gotta be careful with the primes. Good. Solid first engagement. I am wondering. Should I just get that prime out of the way? Let's first of all kill the ones that obviously can die. Wow, very well done. Given that we don't have any more primes, might as well do a bit of a run and gun here into Frostbite. That unfortunately missed. He's now moving further. We're repositioning. Thanks to the Icarus jump, that is a quickie. Getting spotted out is not the end of the world. Killing him is a great reward for that. So, Oscar is out. And I'm tempted to use the battle scanner. Also tempted to get that thing down.
Moving to position.
You know, one easy way of dealing with primes is to freeze them. I don't want it to take over one of us and then continue its stupid abilities. A horrifying gaze from them is, I think, 5 points. 5 points of damage. Now that might trigger. I will go here though.
On the move.
Good. What are we dealing with? Would have triggered, by the way. Yeah, there is a triplet pack. Witch hunters, I think.
We've got admin here.
Wow! He just got triggered. Are you kidding me? This guy just got triggered and he can attack and he then has Bladestone. And they are vanishing through the wall. Okay.
On the move.
That was a pretty OP move. As in overpowered.
Frag out.
This might trigger more. Currently it luckily does not. I want more focus. There we go. And we are full, which is absolutely fantastic. Might as well put our parry up here. I'll think about it in a second. In the meantime, moving up. I don't want to take chances. I want to kill the Spectre whilst it is frozen.
No retreat.
Good, moving over. Another action. Spectre dies. Elite Wrath Commando dies. What a stupid enemy design, by the way. There might be more enemies. Psyching, you gotta be careful, man.
Heading out.
Okay, so that one worked. Dodged. Big fat hit.
Hit the armor.
That gets us into breaching maneuver and back to here. Alright, overwatching. Raptor jump into something stupid. Okay, no one attacked the protected device, which is great because it gives us more time.
X-ray neutralized. Help me some ammo.
Fabulous.
Heading out.
Gotta heal up soon. Moving up, and let's see.
You're gonna be fine.
All right. So that worked out well. Now next up, this here should not trigger. This here should not trigger. And we're moving everybody further up. There's the Witch Hunter. Couple of additional advents. But what did I just see? There was a really, really, really nasty big pack there.
Okay.
Not good. Let's try to do everything in our power to not trigger these guys. Witch Killer. Yeah, these guys are the problematic ones. Bit of a line of sight issue here. I know that there is a big pack right there. I just don't want it to take over our position. Look, we could grenade, but that would trigger the entire pack. And I just mentioned we want to do everything in our power to not do that. Reload. Let's kill this guy. Okay, that clearly didn't work out. That will deal with a witch killer, hopefully. Overwatching here.
No problem,
boss. Moves over. Overwatches. There's the extra pack I was talking about. Luckily, we have not triggered it. Gatekeeper primes. I think they had permanent reanimation. Okay. Not as problematic as I thought it would be. First things first. Remove cover. Secondly, that's the important one, Gatekeeper Prime, free Zerino. Let's go. Let's go.
It's still moving.
Yeah. Damn right, it is still moving. We're amplifying damage on it. Getting back focus, putting in parry, which hopefully that thing will use as an invitation to shoot us. This should kill almost all of them. Shred on top of it, and Gatekeeper hopefully shoots into parry. Good, now we do a little trick, which is handover actions. And we're getting a bit closer. Damn it, that was a hit, unfortunately. Okay. Use another Gatekeeper's Call, that's fine by me. That, on the other hand, was not fine by me. We're now in a loop of a lot of shots. Parry. Okay, but I know how we can kill this guy. XQ6 moves up, and this should be a kill. Okay. What happens to the best? Tell you what, it's very likely it's a psionically active one, so it will get crit by this weapon. That should be a kill. There we go.
All hostiles are down and the area is secure.
Alright, not bad for Protect the Device mission. I had a few more aces up my sleeve afterwards, but that was a good one. That was some very solid rushing into the enemy and getting them down. I think the actual device only took like, what, 13 points of damage because we rushed so quickly. Fantastic. So, listen, instead of letting you run through kind of a strategic layer, which afterwards does not really match what you're going to see when Tapcat's mission is up, I will just look at what we wanted to do at the moment, which was really doing the Shadow Chamber mainly. And I'm trying to remember what we wanted to do. We were expanding. Avatar progress looks fine. I think the next one was a triggered mission. I don't want to speak out of terms because it's a while since I played this. But you're going to see very soon what kind of mission happened. Again, it is this episode, the episode 44 and 48, that are going to be taken out of context. But I hope you still enjoyed the little Royal Rumble that happened. If you did so, leave a comment down below and let me know what you think. And see you in the next episode. Off to you, Tapcat. Take it away.